Siena before you took a long trip up to down to Atlanta and Georgia Tech?
I started working for Paul Hewitt at Siena. We had three really good years there. We went to the MAC championship game all 3 years. Went to the NCAA tournament and the NIT, coached some really good players, some guys that are actually still playing professional basketball overseas. Again, working for Paul Hewitt taught me a lot about the business, the industry, what to do, what not to do, what to look for. Fortunately, I held on to his coattail when he got the Georgia Tech job. He took me with him to Atlanta. We had five really good years there. One of those, we went to the national championship game in 2004. We beat Oklahoma State in the Final Four and then ended up losing to UConn, who were the national champions. So I had a really good time working for Coach Hewitt as well. And then somehow somebody gave me a head coaching job at Jacksonville University in Florida, and I was there for 9 years.
Well, you had a good run down there, a pair of Atlantic Sun championships, also named the Atlantic Sun Coach of the Year after the 2009 season. You got it done down there.
We did pretty good. I had a lot of help. I had a lot of good players. I'm sure all coaches will tell you that. You can't do it without good players and a good staff. I think we did a dynamite job. And one of the things that doesn't go in the bio, if you will, is I'm very proud of graduating 22 out of 22 seniors in 9 years at Jacksonville. And end up being the all-time winningest coach in school history. So very proud of what myself, my staff, and the players were able to do there at Jacksonville.
When you hook up with a player, I mean, there's a fine line you have to, I guess, develop with the respect of a player, the confidence a player has in you, and also that, I hate to use the word father figure, but you're a psychiatrist, psychologist, all these things together wrapped up in one coach.
Sure. I think Coach Turgeon would probably agree. You are many things to many people.
Oh, yeah.
But the people, kids, if you will, the young men that you see 24 hours a day and 7 days a week, you got to try to make sure that you're modeling your life so that the young men try to follow and do everything that you not just say, but you do as well. So it's been very rewarding. Anytime I get a phone call or a text or a Christmas card from a former player, it lets me know that, hey, I did something right in that young man's life.
Tough love, very important, isn't it?
Again, for me, that's what I know. That's how I was raised. John Davis Warren, who was my dad, still living, thank God. I think he was the first one to teach me that tough love. But every coach that I've had, elementary school, junior high, et cetera, has always taught me that. So I tell the players all the time, hey, this may not be right, but this is what I know, and I'm trying to help you be successful.
Coach Turgeon just mentioned a few seconds ago about you and your relationship with Des Wells. This is it for him, last time around in a Maryland uniform this year. And he can be as good as he wants to be, really, because he's got everything going for him.
Sure. He's a dynamite player. As you mentioned, this is it for him. I've said that to him once or twice when I first got here. He'll be the first to tell you. You know, when I first got here, I think we bumped heads several times. I think I made him uncomfortable because I asked him a lot of questions. I made him uncomfortable because I challenged him on and off the court. And I think even now, we have a mutual respect for each other. It's funny that you mentioned Dez, because right before I came here today, he said, hey, I'm out of class early tomorrow. Can I? He actually asked if he could come by the office and watch film. So hopefully it's rubbing off on some other guys, and they're learning their goods and bads so that we can become a good basketball team.
And Cliff, you got to love the makeup of the team, the mixture of young guys, the guys in the middle tier, and the veterans on this basketball team this year.
No, you're exactly right. We've got some really old guys like Rashad Pack, who is going to speak later.
Absolutely.
We've got some young guys. We've got some
veteran
guys. I call
him Mr. Pack.
Mr. Pack. Yeah.
Yeah,
that's very good.
Sure.
But we've got a dynamite group, and I think we've got good parts. And some the two exhibition games that we've had some veteran guys who we know are going to be really good, didn't play very well. But that means the newer guys, they get a chance to step up, and they've all played really well. I think the way Coach Turgeon is coaching this year, and again, I have nothing to compare it to, but I'm saying this year, the way Coach has been coaching our guys, I think it's going to be dynamite, and everybody's going to get a chance to shine, if you will.
One of the great stories about you is when you came to Maryland, I think I called you down to Jacksonville to congratulate you on getting this job, and so as operations manager in basketball, operation director of basketball. It didn't last but a couple of weeks, but he was on the lookout for an assistant coach and looked no further than right down the hallway.
Well, I'm not sure what happened there. I'm not sure, but I was very thankful. I told him when I first interviewed Coach Turgeon, hey, I just want to work for you. I want to help you be successful. I want to come back home, all those things. And so when I got the operations job, I was fine with it. I told my wife, I told my son, hey, this means I won't be out recruiting, so I could be home a little bit more. And then weeks go by, and coach says, hey, I'm just going to put you on the road. Are you okay with that? I said, absolutely. So, again, I just reiterated the same thing. I just want to help Coach Turgeon. I want to help Maryland basketball be successful. So I'm very thankful.
Yeah, it was great. You got a nice little pay raise because of it, too.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that. That was pretty good, too.
He's been tremendous. And, you know, I like guys that don't ask for things. They just work, and then good things happen to him. So he never asked to go on the road, and he could have asked me every day for about 3 weeks, and he never did, not one time. So I knew he was more incapable of going on the road. So it's easy to reward guys when they don't ask for. That's kind of my philosophy. So he's been great. I love that he's here. Heck, he's handled two segments for me. It's been tremendous.
I'll
have to get him back.
If you could handle one for me, we'd really be in good shape.
He can ask questions now, so he might have to do it.
I tell you, the night at Congressional Country Club, when he addressed the surroundings there, everybody gave him a standing ovation, and everybody said, wow, this guy is a tremendous addition to your staff.
No doubt. He has been, and he's just – it's going to take time to get his fingerprints all over the program, but he's slowly, surely doing it. And he's been great for the guys that were here last year that came back, just a fresh attitude, and just, he's always positive about things. So he's been good for them. And he's on them. Yeah, he is on Dez. He's on Dez every day about just about everything. So helps me when I'm not doing my things, recruiting, radio shows, whatever. He's constantly just – has a thumb on these guys that I have him in charge of, and he's making them better people.
Now, Cliff, these guys ready for Friday night?
I definitely think so. You mentioned Dez Wells. I had a meeting with him early today to talk academics, and then we talked about the last exhibition. First thing he says, and you could see it in his eyes, he said, Coach, I'm ready for a game test. I'm ready to play against somebody else where it means something. So I think he is echoing his teammates, and they're ready to play against somebody else.
Coach, it's great having you with us. You know you're welcome here anytime. Anytime at all. And
I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Great addition to the coaching staff, believe me.
I'm glad to be here. Thank you.
Assistant Coach Cliff Warren with us tonight here in the Mark Turgeon.